हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ पवन कुमार बिसरली, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जियोलॉजी, होस्पेट। माई मेल आई डी इज़ PAVANGHP@gmail.com, विच इज़ प्रेजेंट ऑन द स्लाइड। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अप द न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज जू जियोग्राफी ऑफ मैमल्स। सो द क्वेश्चन इज, वॉट इज जू जियोग्राफी? एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स, जू प्लस जियोग्राफी। द एनिमल्स which are found in different parts of the geographical areas of the world, and study of these geographical areas where animals are specifically found in those geographical areas is called as zoogeography. So the question today is, what is the need of studying zoogeography in a whole? Usually many students ask us, why specified mammals or pouched mammals like kangaroos are seen only in case of Australian continent, why not in India? Kiwi birds are predominantly seen in New Zealand, why not in African continent? Were dinosaurs present all over the world or specified to only few parts of the world? Why the monkeys seen in case of Indians are not identical to that of the monkeys present in Australian continent and African continent? So these are some of the different questions that the students always shoot at us. So the answer is study of zoogeography. So this zoogeography enables us to understand how exactly the animals are seen in specified geographical area. What has that geographical area to do with those animals? If possible, we are also going to study how these animals drifted from one continent to the another continent. That is, the animals which are present in India, they may have gone to the European continent because India and European continents are attached. And the possibility of Indian animals moving to the Australian continent is negligible because India and Australian continent are very farther to each other. So does India and America. So these are all the things how we have to understand before going to the geographical topics. So welcome all students once again for geography of mammals. So we are going to continue with the next slide. If you ask a question, are continents were same as they look like today? No, they are not. So continents just move like a paper on a paper water. Neerin melgade yadadru paper hakidre henge move akonta hogutala, adhe reethiyalli continents also move from one part of the earth to the another part of the earth. So the continents, what we are seeing today, what we are analyzing, what we are studying today, were not same in the previous era. Therefore, the animals living today, if you want to study the animal which is living today, when you are studying an animal, you need to study about its habit and habitat. If you want to study the habit and habitat of the animals, then you have to understand the geographical area where that animal is living. If you want to understand the geographical area, then you have to understand when this animal originated and what was the condition of the continents when this animal was originated. So these are the main things that you have to understand if you want to study the animal, its habit, habitat, its behavior, etc. That's the reason why zoogeography of animals makes an important predominant role. So, as per the different continental drifts, that's the name indicates, the continental drift. The continents drift from one part of the earth to the another part of the earth, hence the name continental drift. Students, most probably you may have studied about the geographical realms. That's what we are going to study in the geography. Before that, you could have also studied about the continental drift theory and geological time scale. From in different time scales, the continents were in different positions. That is what we are going to study in the coming slides. in the Hadean era and Archean era, almost in the Hadean era, the world never had any living organisms, and it was a hot ball of mass. It was a hot mass. So the possibility of having living organisms was very, very negligible. Of course, they had some archibacterians, Archeans era. And in Archean era, that is 3.8 to 2.5 billion years ago, slowly the earth started to cool. As a result, you could see different amount of yellow, blue colored oceans forming. In the Cambrian era, which is 514 billion years ago, you could see a large single continent of the world called as Gondwana, which included Africa, South America, Antarctica, India, Archaea, Australia, etc. So three supercontinent of Gondwana had just formed near the South Pole. See, that's the beauty. It was in the South Pole, that is where today we can see Antarctica. Antarctica iro jagadalli you could see India, Australia, African continent, South American continent, England, Wales, etc. Almost all the continents which we are seeing today were found in the South Pole, that is near the Antarctica, which is present today. So that's the beauty of Cambrian era, which was found in 514 billion years ago. In the Middle Ordovician era, which is 558 million years ago, slowly the North, South America, Africa, Antarctica started to move towards the southern region of the, it started to move towards the northern hemisphere, and you could also see India and South China also here. Of course, the continued part of the Ordovician era could be seen in the Silurian era, which was 425 million era million years ago. Laurentia collided with the Baltica, that is northern Europe, closing to the northern branch of the Iapetus Ocean. So this could be seen. Yeah, in the Devonian era, that is 390 million years ago, this Devonian era is called as the Golden Age of Fishes, where you could see the large Gondwana continent, which has started to drift towards the northern part. The Australia has moved towards the equator. India and Saudi, India and Arabian continent, Antarctica are still closely related. Africa and India are neighbors here. South America is very close to the Africa. And Siberia has already moved towards the northern side. So these are some changes which are taking place. The forest grew for the first time in the equatorial region, that is in the Australia, Lemuria and South China, Kazakhstan. In this part, the forest started to grow. So this was seen in case of early Devonian era. Yeah, the same trend could be seen in the Carboniferous era, that is 306 million years ago. So this Carboniferous is also called as Penislavian, and this Carboniferous is mainly divided into three: early Carboniferous, middle Carboniferous and late Carboniferous. At the end of the Carboniferous era, you could see slowly the India has started to move towards the northern side. Almost the Pangean continent has started. So the western half of the Gondwana has separated into Pangaea and Gondwana still is present, and the some countries, continents which was the part of Gondwana has now become the part of the Pangaea, and Paleotethys Ocean, that is sea, is found. Now you could see the beauty of here. The North China, South China were Siberia, Kazakhstan, so which is what we see in the Mongolian part, China, Mongolia and some parts of the Russia, that is former USSR, are not a single continent. They are the stitched parts of the different countries which were seen in the Carboniferous era. That's the Carboniferous in 306 million years ago. The trend could be seen in the late Permian era, that is 255 million years ago. The India has started, the Iran, Tibet, Turkey, India, Australia, Antarctica, South Africa, African continent has slowly started to move towards the equator. Yeah, now you see the beauty of Mesozoic era. You know, this Mesozoic era is called as the golden age of reptiles. This Mesozoic era is again divided into Triassic, Jurassic and Cretaceous period. You know, most of you are familiar with the Jurassic Park film. So this was how the continents had started to drifted in the Mesozoic era. At the end of the Mesozoic era, slowly the continents took its original positions, which we are looking at today. In the 18,000 years ago, that is what we are seeing in the modern structure of the world, there is ice at the poles. The polar ice sheet expands and contracts because of the variations of the Earth's orbit. As a result, you could see the ice ages. And see, 50 million years ago, the Indian continent has collided with the Asian continent. As a result, there is the origination of the Tibetan Plateau and Himalayan mountain ranges. And this Himalayan mountain ranges and Tibet is called as the roof of the world. This is how the modern world looks like. Of course, you're all aware of it. As per the scientist expectation, the future world in 50 million years ago, the Africa and Asia is going to collide and India's will start slowly, it starts to drift. In 250 million years ago from today, the South America continent is going to hit the Africa, and as a result, whole of the South America, North America, Africa, Europe and Asia will form a large huge mass, and this huge landmass is landlocked in a middle small ocean basin which is trapped at the center. So this supercontinent, there will be a supercontinent in the next 250 million era. So this is all about the different landscapes. That is, it's just an introduction, because before studying these things, if I directly go to the geographical parts of the animals, hopefully you are not going to understand. As a result, I made it very clear about the continental drift theory. So I explained to you about the different movements of the continents in different eras and periods of the geographical timescale. So now we are going to come to the geographical realms. So because of the different climatic and topographic conditions, the animals may have passed from one part of the continent to the another part of the continent. So hence, Earth can be divided into six biogeographical regions on the basis of distribution of plants and animals. These regions were called as realms. And this, the word realm was coined by P.L. Sclater in the year 1858. He proposed six geographical realms for birds. Of course, in Alfred Russel Wallace, who is a co-author of Charles Darwin in producing evolution theory by natural selection, in the year 1876, he also adapted and endorsed this type of distribution for all different types of animals. So each realm has unique animals characteristic to each other. So these realms are Palearctic, which includes all of the Asia and Europe and northern part of the Africa, Oriental, that is the Indian subcontinent, Nearctic, that is the North American continent, Neotropical, that is the South American continent, Australian realm and Antarctic realm. So these are the six different these are the seven different, but Africa, okay, some people, what they do is this Afrotropical and some part of the Palearctic, they fuse to make it as Ethiopian. So that's how six or seven geographical realms comes into action. So coming to the Palearctic region, which is the largest of the six regions and covering an area of 14 million square miles. So in this region, Europe, Asia, north of Himalaya and northern parts of Africa comes under this region. So this region shows wide range of temperature fluctuations because the area is huge. It also shows wide range of fluctuations in amount of rainfall, of course it does. It includes polar Arctic regions, because and some part of the regions of this Palearctic is ice filled, that is snow, has snow. On this northern side, it shows temperature conditions. The Eastern Asia, that is towards the Eastern Asia towards the Japan, China, etc. It shows the deciduous forest. In the northern region, steppe grasslands are present. As the Palearctic region is the largest region of the different geographical realms, hence it shows fluctuation in the physical and climatic features, as I said it earlier. Hence, for the study of fauna and flora, it has been divided into European subregion, that is Northern and Central Europe, Black Sea and Caucasians. They found Myogale is the only one genus of mammal which is present. Mammals like wolf and moles. Moles, it's a type of what you call hegna, so that's a type of mole which are common in these subregions. So the remaining parts of the Europe, that is the Mediterranean subregion, is seen. It has 124 families of different terrestrial vertebrates like present. Mammals like elephants, shrews, hyena, and porcupines, that is mulhandi what you call, are seen in these subregions. Coming to the Siberian subregion. Siberian subregion is mainly seen in case of North Asia, and Himalayas are included in it. Some parts of Himalayas. So Northern Asia, which mainly includes the Russia. So Russian Siberian climate, Siberian winter of Russia is very dangerous, which was proven to be fatal even at the time of Hitler. Hitler lost his major part of his army during the attack on Siberia. So 94 families of vertebrates are included. Families of musk deer, kasturi mruga anta heltivala, so thus musk deer and moles are confined to this subregion. So musk deer bage gotide, kasturi mruga. The male musk deer has a special type of resin in its stomach called as musk, which is very aromatic. ಅದನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಆ ಕಸ್ತೂರಿಯನ್ನು ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅರೋಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಅದನ್ನು ದೇವ್ರ ಪೂಜೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಪರ್ಪಸಸ್. ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಬ್ ರೀಜನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಂಚೂರಿಯನ್ ಸಬ್ ರೀಜನ್. ಮಂಗೋಲಿಯಾ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ರಷ್ಯಾ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಂಗೋಲಿಯಾ. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಂಗ್ ಡೇಸ್. Mongolia, Japan, Korea and Manchuria are included in this region. Mammals like Siberian langur, great panda, tufted deer, Chinese water deer are very common in this Manchurian subcontinents of the Palearctic region. Please do refer some of the other examples of mammals have been given here in the Palearctic part, like camel, deer, wolves, horses, pigs, hedgehogs, etc. Fruit bats, panthera, bears, etc. Dog, cats, squirrels, they are very common. They are omnipresent. So this is all about the Palearctic region or Palearctic geographical realm. So now we'll take one special realm that is very separated from the whole world. That is, it's a nation and also a continent by itself. So what is that? Yes, of course, it is a Australian realm or Australian region. Of course, as I said, Australian region is nothing but an Australian continent, Australian country and Australian realm. It includes New Zealand, New Guinea and nearby islands of the Pacific Ocean. So, sub-regions of the Australian region, the realm is divided into four sub-regions. What are they? Now we are going to discuss. First one is Australian subregion. In that 34 genera of marsupials are included, that is marsupials are pouched animals. So hence this Australian subregion is called as home of marsupials. Second region is Malayo-Austro region, that is Austro-Malayan region. So this region includes Malayan Archipelago Islands. That's a beauty. This Malayan Archipelago Islands, so the Darwin, Charles Darwin, he studied in other islands ಆದರೆ ಈ ಡಾರ್ವಿನ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸಬ್ ಆಥರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತ ಕೋ ಆಥರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಆಲ್ಫ್ರೆಡ್ ರುಸೆಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲೆಸ್, ಅವನು ಬೇರೆ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡಿಗೆ ಹೋದರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲೆಸ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ದ ಆರ್ಚಿ ಪಿಲಾಗೋ ಮಲಯನ್ ಆರ್ಚಿ ಪಿಲಾಗೋ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ದ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಚಿ ಪಿಲಾಗೋ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬೋತ್ ಹೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ದ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಅಪ್ ಬೈ ದ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಚಿಪಿಲಾಗೋ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಚಾರ್ಲಸ್ ಡಾರ್ವಿನ್ ಹೋಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟು, ಮಲಯನ್ ಆರ್ಚಿಪಿಲಾಗೋ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪರ್ ದ ವಾಲೆಸ್ ಆಲ್ಫ್ರೆಡ್ ರುಸೆಲ್ ವಾಲೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಡೆಂಡ್ರೋಲಾಗಸ್, ಡೈರಸ್, ಮಾರ್ಸಿಪಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಲಯನ್ ಸಬ್ ರೀಜನ್. ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷಿಯನ್ ಸಬ್ ರೀಜನ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷಿಯನ್ ಐಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೌನಾ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಪುವರ್. Now coming to the New Zealand sub-region, in this sub-region, snakes are absent, completely snakes are absent. This may be a competitive exam question. Which sub-region in the geographical realm where snakes are completely absent, that is New Zealand sub-region. The Spinodon, which is a living fossil, is confined to this region only. If you get a Spinodon, then it is New Zealand sub-region. In this region, kiwi flightless birds are present, hence the people call theirs. ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಕಿವೀಸ್. ಯು ನೋ ಕಿವೀಸ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಟೀಮ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಕಿವೀಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಕಿವಿ ಫ್ಲೈಟ್ಲೆಸ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೀನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡಿಯನ್ ಸಬ್ ರೀಜನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಿವಿ ಇಸ್ ಅ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂಜಿಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ರ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. So in some previous slides, we had given examples of some marsupial animals present in different parts of the Australian realm. So now we are going to take up the new realm, that is Afrotropical realm. It's also called as Ethiopian realm. So that is the southern part, that is from just a little part, northern parts of the Africa comes under Palearctic, and some parts of and southern parts of the African continents comes under this Ethiopian or Afrotropical continent, that is realm. So this realm includes Africa, Sahara Desert, which is the largest desert, southern parts of America, Arabia, Madagascar Islands are also included. So this region shows extensive desert on the northern side, that is the Sahara Desert, which is called as the Sahara. On the western side, there is a thick forest. See the beauty. North kadege high, large desert ide. Western kadege thick forest ide. Rest of the Africa shows green land. So that's the interesting thing. This Ethiopian region was divided into four sub-regions, namely East African sub-region, West African sub-region, South African sub-region, and Malagasy sub-region. So now we'll come to the main part of the geographical realm in which we are living, that is the Oriental realm, that is the Indian subcontinent, which is seen in blue color here. So this Oriental region includes Indian subcontinent, Ceylon, that is Sri Lanka, Burma, Philippines, Formosa, and some parts of China form this region. This Oriental region, Indian subcontinent ಅಂತ ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಂಟಾರ್ಟಿಕಾ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಏಷ್ಯಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಟ್ ದ ಏಷ್ಯಾ 50 million years ago. ಸೊ ದ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವೆದರ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಾಂಟಿನೆಂಟ್, ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಕಾಂಟಿನೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಏಷ್ಯನ್ ಕಾಂಟಿನೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ is now a part of Asia. India, yav Asia continental barate antu Asian continent anta heltivi. So this India, though it is now a part of Asian continent, it has its own specific race. Also it has its own specific regions, geographical parts, climate, etc. As a result, the scientists had a confusion whether to make this Oriental region as a part of Asia or to make it as a separate continent. As these two geographical parts are attached to each other, hence the Oriental region is now made as a part of Asia, but Indian Oriental region, that is Indian continent, is renamed as Asia Indian subcontinent. So that's the interesting fact about the Oriental region. So the Oriental region is mainly divided into four subregions: Indian subregion, Ceylonian subregion, Indochina subregion, and Indo-Malayan subregion. Region includes North India, central part. It starts from the root of Himalayas and extend to the Malabar coast. So this region shows plains and deserts. It shows temperature and tropical condition. In this region, antelopes, Indian bison, and the cardamom, so that Indian bison, and black elephant, that is Indian elephants, which is single horned, single tusked elephant, are present in this Indian subcontinent. Sri Lankan subcontinent includes small Indian peninsula. It shows loris, kadapapa anta helthivi. This loris is a Karnataka's state animal. Elephants, equas, rat, and bandicoots are present in this Ceylonian sub region. See this, I have given some examples, 14 different examples of different animals and mammals present in the Ethiopian region. And see, this point, Ethiopian region mammals show resemblances with the mammalian fauna of the Oriental region. That means, that's because in the previously, these two, that is the Ethiopian continent and Oriental continent, were very near to each other. They were the neighbors. They were sharing the borders. As a result, there is a similarities of different animals present in Ethiopian region to the animals present in the Oriental regions. Andre ondanondu kaldali Africa matte India, they were very neighbors. As a result, nam India dalli siktakanta animals matte Africa dalli siktakanta animals ge some resemblance ide. Of course, svalpa modification agirtare, that is due to the long era of evolution. But yet, they have some resemblance to each other. So we'll take up another geographical realm, that is the neotropical realm. So this neotropical region is also called as South American realm. This region shows tropical conditions. Of course, this is very near to the equator, hence it shows tropical conditions, hot climate conditions. The southern part of the South America shows temperate zones. Because of these varied environmental conditions, luxuriant forests, deserts, plains, and rivers are common. That's the reason why Brazil contains the largest river called as the Amazon. Of course, this neotropical continent is mainly divided in Chilean subcontinent, Chile, Brazilian subcontinent, which includes the largest river. See, the largest river is Amazon. Longest river is Nile. Remember this. So Mexican subcontinent and West Indies subcontinent. West Indies subcontinent is also called as Caribbean subcontinent. So now we are going to take up the last realm, that is Nearctic region, that is the North American realm. Also, this Nearctic region, which is the North American realm, shows great variations in climatic and conditions and temperatures. The North Greenland part, so this North Greenland part is completely frozen and ice can be seen. Ranges of mountains extends from north to south. They are Atlas Mountains. In the southwest of the North America, deserts are also seen. So you can see completely frozen ice in the Greenland, mountain parts in the Atlas, and South American deserts are also seen in this Nearctic realm. So this Nearctic region is subdivided into Californian subregion, Rocky Mountainian subregion, that is Atlas Mountain, Allegheny Mount region, and Canadian subregion. So some of the families, that is the 24 families of mammals, are seen in this Nearctic regions. Mammals like squirrels, moles, rabbits, hares. Rabbit ko hares ko difference hai. Please remember that. Rabbits, hares, beavers, cats, bats, deer, bears, weasels, opossum, porcupines, armadillo. Armadillo antana chippu handi anta helthivi. So these armadillos are also present in the Nearctic realm. So in this topic we discussed about the 6 or 7 different geographical realms, some subregions present in them, animals, mammals which are seen in those continents, in those realms, and how exactly the earth had modified itself in the different durations of time, and how different animals are connected to the different animals, because in one or the other time these two continents were very near to each other. As a result, there is a line, that is what we call them as Wallace lines. So in this geography, I think the detailed study of geography reveals you that how animals originated in one continent, how animals diverged from one part of the continent to the another part of the continent, how adaptive evolutionary radiations can be seen in different parts of the world of different animals. So this is all about the geography of the mammals. So if you have any doubts, question, clarifications, please ask. In the first slide I told you about my email ID. Once again I am going to repeat, pavanghb@gmail.com. you can mail me, you can contact me anytime. So I am very open to ask, very open to your queries. Let me confine now. This is what geography in detail lag hogi dini. So let me confine this topic to the examination point of view. As per the VSKUB examination point of view is concerned, only study how what are the 6 different geographical realms present in this world, what are the geographical areas the countries comes under, these 5 to 6 examples coming under these geographical areas. Climatic condition is irbodu, whether it is temperate or temperament or tropical. Is there any sub regions nenpitkolangitto andre nenpitkolri, bekagilla antandre bidri, no problem. So major agi yav yav realms idave, yav yav realms olagade yav climatic conditions ide, whether it is temperate or tropical, what are the sub regions, 5 to 6 examples of animals coming under these geographical realms. ಇಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಓದ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇನಫ್ ಫರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ. ಸೊ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಎನಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಕ್ವೈರೀಸ್, ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮೀ. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ಮೈ ಮೇಲ್ ಐ ಡಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ಸ್, ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಟು ಕ್ವೆಶನ್. ಸೊ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಒನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಯೋರ್ ಪ್ರೀಷಿಯಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೀ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಒನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್.